praise you. I praise you, Jesus. Father God Almighty, Jesus, I praise you because of the marriages, oh God. Jehovah, may you help, oh Lord. Help marriages, oh God Almighty. Those marriages, oh Lord, that Jehovah, Lord Jesus Christ, are not together, God. Are not, Jehovah, Lord, in unity, God. May you bring unity and peace in the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord, King of glory, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we worship you. Father, we worship you. We pray, Jehovah, Lord, for husbands, oh Lord. Jehovah, the head of the families, oh Lord. How I pray, Jehovah, Lord, for your wisdom. How I pray, Jehovah, Lord, for your word. In the mighty name of Jesus upon them, oh Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says that God, your word says, oh Lord, that Lord Jesus Christ, you this. Jehovah God Almighty, that's you. Ah, God Almighty, Jehovah, you don't like this false, oh God Almighty. Jehovah God, that because, Lord Almighty, you need for families, oh Lord, to stay together in unity, oh Lord, to bring up a good generation. Good generation, King of glory. I pray and I speak, oh Lord, a blessing to the marriages, oh God. I speak a blessing, oh Lord. I speak a blessing, Jesus, in the marriages, oh God. Father, I worship you, Lord. I worship you, King of glory. Thank you because of wives, oh Lord. Jehovah God Almighty, may you give them wisdom too on how to live, oh Lord, on how to bring up families in the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord. Father, blessed be your name. Blessed be your name, King of glory. You are wonderful and you are holy, God. Thank you, Lord, for you are holy and you are wonderful, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, because of this church. Thank you because of Siva, Lord. We are going praises, oh Lord. Jehovah, may you guide us through. May you help us, oh Lord. Help the leadership of this church in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Help the leadership of this church, oh God. Father, pray that, Lord Jesus, your wisdom and your knowledge, oh God, shall be upon our pastor, God. Shall be upon the leaders, oh Lord, of this church. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord. Father, we worship you. Father, we worship you. Father, we worship you. And Lord, I declare your word in the book of Deuteronomy. That Lord, wherever we step our foot, oh God, you have given us, Lord, as a possession. That Lord Jesus Christ, we are the heads and not the tails, oh God. Father, I worship you because Lord, we are blessed in the villages. We are blessed, oh Lord, in the cities, oh Lord. And wherever and whatever, Lord, thing that we touch, oh God, you are going to bless it, oh God. Father, pray for expansion, oh Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Spiritual expansion, oh Lord. Financial expansion, Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh Lord, King of glory. I worship you, Lord. Thank you because of praise and worship. As praise and worship is coming, oh Lord, may you use them, Lord, Jehovah God Almighty, for your glory and honor, oh Lord. I worship you and I bless your name. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray and give thanks. Amen. And amen. Hallelujah. 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 Praise and worship. Welcome. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Praise God. Praise God again. We are so glad to be in the house of the Lord today. And we are ready to give him our best, to give him our praise, to give him our dance and our worship. Yes.
Ah!
every challenge I may face. Lord, I'm filled with your glory. I'm filled with your grace. I am filled with your favor to overcome every challenge I may face. That same power that conquered the grave lives in me. Hey, oh, that same power that rescued the earth lives in me. I'm ready.
I'm
rolling.
I'm
oh, prevailing over all circumstances. I'm blessed. Hey, oh, I'm blessed. Oh, I'm blessed.
I live a
oh, I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm blessed.
I live a glorious life.
Hey, give me some. Give your best dance to the Lord. Come on. Hey, somebody shout amen. I'm filled with your glory, I'm filled with your grace. I am filled with your favor to overcome every challenge I may face. Lord, I'm filled with your glory, I'm filled with your grace. I am filled with your favor to overcome every challenge I may face. That same power
that conquered the grave
lives in me. Oh, that same power
that
rescued the earth lives in me. Oh, yeah. I'm ruling.
I'm blessed. I live a
hey,
I'm ready.
I'm ruling. Who prevailing
over all circumstances?
I'm blessed. I'm blessed.
I live a glorious.
I'm ready.
I'm
ruling.
kama wewe Bwana. Hakuna Mungu kama wewe Bwana. Oh, unaweza. Hey, hey, hey. Hakuna Mungu kama wewe Bwana. Mototero kolayo Nzambe, mototero kolayo Yesu, unaweza,
unaweza, hakuna Mungu kama wewe Bwana.
I'm
Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We bless your name, O God, Lord Almighty. We magnify your name, Jesus, and we bless your name, O God. That there is no man, God, Jesus, who is like you, Lord. Great are you, Jesus. Great are you, Lord, King of glory. Great are you, King of glory. We worship you, Lord. We magnify your name. Come on, somebody, worship God this morning. Somebody worship God this morning. Somebody worship God this morning. Father, we worship you. We worship you, King of glory. We worship you, King of glory. There is no man, Lord Jesus, who's like you, Lord. We worship you this morning, O Lord. We magnify your name, O Lord, this morning. We worship you, Lord. Oh, King of glory, we magnify your name. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, King of glory. We thank you, King of glory. How we magnify your name. How we thank you, Lord. How we worship you. How we worship you this morning, Lord. We bow before your throne this morning to worship your name. To worship you, Jesus. To worship you, King of glory. To worship you, Lord. Oh, you are amazing, God. You are amazing, God. You deserve all the glory. You deserve all the honor, God. You deserve all the worship, King of glory. You are such an amazing God. We bow to worship you. We bow to lift up your name, O Lord. We bow to worship you, Lord. Hallelujah, we worship you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
At the center of it all,
oh, Lord Jesus.
It's you that I see. It's you that I see. Jesus, at the center. At the center of it all,
it's you that I see. It's you that I see.
At the center, at the center,
at the center of it all, it's you that I see. It's you that I see. It's you that I see.
There is power in your name. Miracles happen in your name.
As you lift a voice in prayer, it's you that I see.
There is power, there is power,
there is power in your name. Miracles happen in your name. As we lift our voice in prayer, that I see, it's you that I see.
Oh, at the center of this church, it's you that I see.
Oh,
it's you that I see. At the center,
at the center of your, it's you that I see. It's you that I see.
Oh, there is power.
There is power in your name.
That I see, for you are.
as we lift our voice in prayer. It's you that I see, Lord. It's you that I see, Jesus.
It's you that I see.
And there is power. There is power in your name. Miracles happen in your name. As we lift, as we lift, as we lift our
hands
in prayer, our prayer
is you that I see.
Our voice
is you that I see.
And Lord Jesus, you are bigger, Lord. You are bigger, you are bigger.
You are bigger, bigger than the mountain. You are high, stronger than the strong.
You are.
Greater than the great,
you are bigger.
Greater than the
great,
you
are bigger. And
you are stronger than the strong.
You are
higher than the
mighty. And you
are bigger than the great.
You are greater,
bigger than the biggest.
You are higher,
higher than the
You are higher, higher than the air.
Yeah.
Jesus. Hallelujah. And listen, at the center of it all, it's only Jesus that I see. Hallelujah. At the center of the earth,
it's you that I see. It's you that I see.
And you know, listen to me. Miracles happen in your name.
Yes.
Oh, demons tremble in your name. Father, we worship you. Once more, at the center of it all. At the center of the earth,
it's you that I see. It's you that I see.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Amen.
So the reason that I call Andrew here, because for 10 good years, this brother has been married, okay? And for 10 good years, this brother has been waiting for a child. And guess what? God did it. God did it. So, the Sifa way, right? The way the men's ministry right here in Sifa Church, right? The way we do it, right? We know there's so many hoods out there, right? But there's nothing like fatherhood. It's the best hood, all right? So we want to welcome this brother fatherhood, right? In a special way, all right? Stand right there, all right? As I invite pastor to come so that to bless the blessing. But you're not giving it to you, Vigenedi, right? I want to give an opportunity to the fathers out there, to the men out there, to those who are praying for a blessing like he just had. My cash up handle is $ Peter Ngiri. Ukisikia kuna upako na unataka ku bless our brother here, shoot me up a little something. Alright? Ntampatia. Study your care, ntampatia. Amen. $ Peter Ngiri. Amen. Pastor.
Amen. Praise the Lord. So this time we take this opportunity to hand over this blessing from the men. Amen. God bless you, increase you, Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. So the people behind me, no, wanna talk shangilia. Amen. Let's do it. Amen.
Tunasherekea ushindi wa Bwana. Jina la Yesu ni ngome imara.
Tunasherekea ushindi wa Bwana. Jina la Yesu ni ngome imara.
Oh, tunasherekea ushindi wa Bwana. Jina la Yesu ni ngome imara.
Tunasherekea ushindi wa Bwana.
Oh, tunasherekea ushindi wa Bwana. Jina la Yesu ni ngome imara.
Tunasherekea ushindi wa Bwana. Jina la Yesu ni ngome imara.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Worship, you can take your seat. Amen. Amen. All right. I want to be a good steward of the time that has been assigned to me. All right. So we want to welcome the first time guest to Sifa Church. Karibuni sana, put your hands together for the first time as you can have a seat. All right. So, a quick housekeeping rules, right? As you go out on your right, that's where we find the bathroom. It's the men's and the women's, right? Make sure you read the signs correctly. Amen. Now, on this coming Saturday, on the 26th, we have a women's ministry. If you have not RSVP, please, there's a number to be shared for Anne and Shiro. It's going to be at 12025 Richmond Avenue. It's actually an apartment complex, their clubhouse. So women, you are invited to attend that conference. I believe it's going to be at, help me out. What time, women? What time is your conference? 4 to 7, amen? 4 to 7, you don't want to miss it. On the same day, right here at church, we have a college and career prep, right? Courtesy of the men's ministry and Brother Steve in the back. Put your hands together for, right? So it's college and career prep, amen? So please, Letenio Toi, come and get the information, right? We want our kids by the time when I graduate high school to have at least an associate degree. Amen. Information is out there. It needs to be shared. Amen. Amen. So it's going to be here from 9 to noon. 9 to noon, February the 26th, this coming Saturday. Amen. Amen. Now, every Friday, every other Friday, we have prayers and worship session. All right? It's at Zoom, right? Akuna excuse. Akuna malinenda, right? So, every other Friday. So, we just had one last Friday, right? You don't know what you're missing. You know, log in and come and let us share the word of God. Amen? Amen. Now, we're going to go to the best part of it. Tithe and offerings, right? As soon as I do, the tithe and offerings and then pray for the kids, I will invite Grace. Grace Kaberenge. So, let us go mdundiko, right? Let us go mdundiko. So, today we are praising and worshiping like none other day, okay? So, you know, Grace has come all the way, and she is ready to shut the house down. Amen. Amen. So for our Cash App handle is $CFOChurch. Amen. $CFOChurch. $CFOChurch. And then there's actually a Zelle. I'm sure they have a number. It'll be posted in the back. You can share that as well. Amen. Let us pray for the tithe and offerings and pray for the kids. Father, in Jesus' name, we want to thank you for these giftings that you have allowed us to have, oh God. We thank you because of these children, oh God. They are smart. They are beautiful. They are kind, oh God, our God. A reflection of what you have put into us, oh God, our God. You have allowed us, oh God, our God, to be stewards of these children. A gift from you to us to be able to take care of them, oh God, our God. Dear God, I declare and decree, oh God, our God, that their beginning, oh God, our God, will be good, oh God. Their ending will be good, oh God. These children will inherit and eat the best of the best this land has to offer, oh God, our God. They will shine at school, oh God, our God. Open their minds, oh God. Allow it to receive, oh God. Dear God, I thank you because of our tithe and offerings, oh God. It's only a tenth, oh God, you're asking back, oh God, of what you have allowed us to have. We thank you for the graces. We thank you for the graces, oh God. And we want to partake in putting that seed back onto good ground, oh God. Allow it to manifest. Allow it, oh God, oh God, to come forth and produce, oh God, oh God. That little seed that we put on the ground, oh God, allow it to be, oh God, a sequoia tree, oh God. Oh God, we praise you. We glorify your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray and believe. Everybody say amen. Now, Brother Peter Obedi, as you get ready for Sister Grace, we welcome Sister Grace.
Hello. Praise God. Mwana Yesu asifiwe. Tafadhali, kuja mnitie nguvu huko nyuma. It's a simple song. You just ride along. You too. Napenda company. Thank you so much. My name is Grace from San Antonio. I'm going to do a song that says hallelujah in the morning, hallelujah in the noontime, hallelujah in the evening. Everybody can sing along with us. Sawa? Thank you. Give me the song.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Other one? Okay. Do you have a rhythm guitar somewhere? Rhythm? Yeah. I can try. I think if I do it alongside you, it's going to be nice. It's going to be a move. Usio wakati wakukata tamaa. Huu ndio wakati wakusonga mbele. Huu sio wakati wakuwa mnyonge. Huu ndio wakati wakuwa na nguvu. Huu sio wakati wakuwa mgonjwa. Huu ndio wakati wakupona sasa. Wanajeshi mjiandae, wanajeshi mjiandae. Eh, oyo yo yo. Wanajeshi mjiandae, wanajeshi mjiandae. Jiambie mwanajeshi, mwanajeshi ujiandae, mwanajeshi ujiandae. Mwana jeshi ujiandae, mwana jeshi ujiandae. For those who don't understand Swahili, this is not the time to be weak. This is the time to be strong. This is not the time to be sick. This is the time to be healed by the name of Jesus. This is not the time to stay back. This is the time to move forward with all the odds that are here in this world with the COVID. This is the time to move forward. Can I hear some 10 hallelujahs in the house of the Lord? Nisikie vigelegele kama 20,000 jamani.
Hallelujah.
Asante sana. This is the time to push. I have a song on YouTube. It says, push your miracle. Pray until something happens. perfect until something happens. Push on until something happens. Pray until something happens. Push your miracle today. Hallelujah. Tell your friend, push. Ambia mwenzako, push. Sukuma hadi kitu kionekane. Hallelujah. Asante sana.
The day when I had a
out of my mind. I worship you. I worship you. Let me hear everybody sing.
Jesus, I love you so.
With all of my hands. With all of my mind.
Woo!
I worship you. Everybody sing.
Jesus, I love you so.
With all of my mind. I worship you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm short. Mungu aliye hai.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Grace, for that good singing. God bless you so much. So, I know many of you are here because of our brother Joel Luaga. Praise the Lord. Don't panic. Praise the Lord. I see some of you have panicked already. You're not seeing him. You're wondering, Kwani, actually find a false advertisement. Praise the Lord. Don't panic. Be at ease. Praise the Lord. Everything is under control. Amen. He'll be here shortly. Praise the Lord. There was just a little bit of a delay, but he will be here. Amen. But as we are waiting for him, you have me. Praise the Lord. God is good. And all the time. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. So, I'm going to share briefly about relationships. Praise the Lord. Tomorrow is Valentine's Day. And I heard some men are going for men's conference. So I'm here to discourage them not to go for men's conference, because I had I saw the roster is at 8 a.m. Turn off your phone. Amen. So I'm going to read from the book of Genesis chapter 2 verse 8. It says, the Lord planted a garden eastward in Eden, and he put the man whom he had formed. And out of the ground, the Lord God made every tree grow that is pleasant to the sight and good for food. The tree of life was also in the midst of the garden, and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Now, a river went out of Eden to water the garden, and from there it parted and became four river heads. The name of the first was Pishon. It is one that skirts the whole land of Havilah, where there is gold. The gold of the of that land is good. Delium and onyx stones are there. The name of the second river is Gihon. It is one which goes around the whole land of Cush. The name of the third river is Hiddekel. It is the one which goes east, the east of Assyria. The fourth river is Euphrates. And the Lord God took the man and put him in the garden of Eden to tend and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat, for in the day that you eat of it you shall surely die. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. Let us say together. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. Praise the Lord. The Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. Then he says, I will make him a helper comparable to him. Praise the Lord. So, hey, Pastor Tina. Praise the Lord. Come usalimia watu. Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Na wasalimia sana kanisa la Sifa. For those of you who don't know, about 3 years ago, I was associate pastor to Pastor Clement. Hallelujah. You have a good man of God. Mnamtumisha naye mpenda Mungu. Nilikana Pastor Clement, and when I left, he laid hands on me together with the elders. I regularly pray for Sifa. Hallelujah. And I am so blessed to see this wonderful facilities. Stand behind the man of God. He will take you far. And may God bless all of you. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Amen. I had not seen you. Who else have I not seen? Praise the Lord. Amen. So, the Lord out of, so it says that I will make him a helper comparable to him. And I just want to briefly speak about relationships today. I wasn't planning to go deep because we have the event, we have our singer coming. And I will also still not go deep because I just want to touch on the surface. Then next Sunday, I'll go deep. Praise the Lord. So in life, one of the things that you realize is that you cannot live life alone as an island. You need relationships. Praise the Lord. You need people. You need people. It doesn't matter whatever you do, you need people. Praise the Lord. And one of the things that we go to school, all of us have been to school, and one of the main things that we need to learn in school is relationships, how to relate with people. In fact, we need to learn that more than even the grades we go and yearn for, we go learn. Because one of the things that I learned is that there are the people who are book smart, and then there are people that are street smart. And one of the things I've realized is that it seems that the people that are street smart kind of make it better in life than the people that are book smart. Praise the Lord. Because they know how to relate. They know how to relate with people. Praise the Lord. For example, if you are at a job, there are people that are very good at the job. There are others who are not good at all, but somehow they get promoted. And the ones who are very good, they always complain, nobody sees my job. Nobody. It's because they do not relate. Praise the Lord. You know, one of the things I learned, but I learned this after I left employment. I wish I knew it when I was employed. I came to realize the best thing you need to do is to become best friends with your manager or your boss. Praise the Lord. Don't worry about doing the job. Just become the friend. Amen. You know, just become the friend. And you know, one of the things I learned that you promote the people you like. Praise the Lord. You don't promote people that are going to give you trouble. You promote the people you like. There are people that are very excellent in their job, but you don't want them to promote them because you know who you ukimuleta ataleta shida. Praise the Lord. So you promote the people you like, and you wonder, how comes? Then, and you know, there's that office friendship. You know, it's funny. There's a friend of mine, we used to work somewhere in an office, and there was this other person who used to be in the same office. And this guy, we were buddies. This other one was our friend, but not our friend really. Praise the Lord. So there are things we used to do in that office. This other person does has no clue. But they say they work there, but they have no clue that they're inside politics. Praise the Lord. And you see, one of the things you have to understand is that you have to understand or find a way of getting into that inside politics. Praise the Lord. Where decisions are made, be in there. Amen. And there are some friends of mine here who are, for example, let's take an example of Peter Ngiri. If Peter Ngiri became the mayor of Houston, amen, you know, definitely he would give me a good position somewhere. He'll not worry about my competency. He's my friend. Praise the Lord. Look at some of the people that are normally appointed in positions of power. They're not competent. They are just good friends of the person in power. Praise the Lord. You know, you have to understand relationships. Relationships are critical and they are vital. Amen. You know the thing is that you have to be strategic when you are forming relationships. It's not about knowing so many people. It's about knowing the right people. Praise the Lord. You know, there are people who know so many people, but nobody can help you. Of all that phone list, you go through your phone list, there's not even a single person that can help you. It is time to start changing your phone list. Praise the Lord. And start relating with people that can help you. Amen.
I came to realize that one of the reasons for David succeeded is because he volunteered to do a job that nobody else wanted to do. Praise the Lord. He said, we have a Goliath problem and I am volunteering to take care of it. You know, some of us, we go to work and we try to do the minimum possible that is equitable to our pay. But one thing you have to understand is that you need to start finding out what gives my boss a sleepless night. And start saying, let me start taking care of that problem. Praise the Lord. I'm telling you, if you start taking care of that problem, you will be, when they start discussing who they need to promote, guess who they'll talk about first? They'll be talking about you because you solved a problem for them. You see, David was not an insider. In fact, Saul did not even know where David came from before he solved the problem. But after he solved the problem, now Saul started inquiring, who is this person? Where do they come from? What about? And you see, that created a relationship. Praise the Lord. This world, even the highest office, we do not vote for the person who is competent to do the job. We vote for the person we like. Praise the Lord. We don't care whether they can work or not. Praise the Lord. For example, think about our politics in Africa. Some of the guys we elect there cannot do the job. But we like them. That's why we vote them in. Praise the Lord. Now, if such an important job is the person gets in there because people like him, what about the other jobs? Praise the Lord. You see, don't be an island. Don't be somebody who says, I don't care what people think about me. Start creating relationships. Praise the Lord. And you see, God says, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make for him a helper comparable to him. And here I have a message for men. I was, for those who, in, there was a statistic that was released a few days ago. And he said that people in diaspora sent back home around $422 billion. And they started listing the people that received the money. And the people that received more than 50% of the money were mothers. In fact, fathers were like number five, number six down the list. Praise the Lord. And I started wondering, how comes fathers were not really getting money as much? And I realized that it's because fathers and their relationship with their children sometimes is not very good. Praise the Lord. You find that sometimes we fathers, we are very busy with our jobs or our business. We don't really care about the day-to-day activities of our children, unlike the mothers. So as a result, the child's heart starts drawing to the mother, not as much as it is with the father. Praise the Lord. Like I remember, I had a very good father. I had a very good father. My father was, he was very present in my life. In fact, since I was in standard, let's say standard one to standard four, he used to take me to school every day. And if he was to miss, he would make sure somebody else comes to pick me. But he made sure he got me to school every day from class one to class four. Then after that, I kind of became independent and I was able to go to school by myself. But he was there. He was present. But as we got older, it seems like we were more closer to our mom than our dad. And I realized this because as a father was a bit strict, doesn't joke as much. And you see, with mom, the other, you joke, you crack, you know, you are free. And I was like, we need to find out as men how we can make our children free with us. Praise the Lord. You find, like sometimes if we want something, we would go tell our mom to tell our dad. We know that our father is the one who's giving the money, but we go through our mom. Now, if your children go through the mom to come to you, you need to break that middleman. Praise the Lord. Amen. Don't let their mother speak for them. Let them speak for themselves. Have a direct connection with your kids. Praise the Lord. Because guess what? When they start sending money, now the way you used to send through the mother, they will also be sending through the mother. And chances are that money, by the time it gets to you, it will be taxed. Praise the Lord. And it may not be 10%. It may be 90% taxed. Praise the Lord. So cut the middleman. Amen. Let your children come to you directly. If they ask, if the mom comes and tells you about it, don't say no or yes. Go to the children directly and ask them, what were you saying? What did you tell mom? Okay, this is what you want. You know, build that bridge. Praise the Lord. Because now, if we don't do that, guess what? You will be neglected as a father. I have watched and I've seen that. Like, for example, those of us who are here, guess who we invite here more? We invite our mothers and we leave our fathers in the village. Praise the Lord. You see, why? Because that relationship is not very strong. Amen. As fathers, we need to have strong relationships with our children. Amen. Because when we have those strong relationships, it's going to be well for us in the future. When we are old, when we cannot produce dollars, it's going to be well for us. Amen. Now, the Bible says that God created, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him. And out of the ground, the man created the field, and he made Adam to name all the animals, everything. And the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam. And he slept, and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. And the rib, which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. Praise the Lord. Now I'm going to say something. It's not serious. Don't take it personally. Praise the Lord. And let me just say that I heard it from Joel Osteen. Praise the Lord. So if you want to go throw stones, don't throw them here. Go to Lakewood. Praise the Lord. Now, man asked, God told man, I'm going to make a wife for you. And then man described the kind of woman he wants. And then God says, that's going to cost you an arm and a leg. Then the man asked God, what can I get for a rib? Praise the Lord. And the rest is history. Amen. So, but this is the thing. God created man, and then he created woman. You see, the thing about it is that the scripture says that, and the Lord God caused deep sleep to fall on man, and he slept, and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. And Adam said, this is the bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Praise the Lord. There is a big question that people ask about polygamy. They say, is it a sin to be polygamous? And I normally say that I have a helper here. And I normally say that when whatever God did first, the law of first mention, whatever God did first, it should guide us Praise the Lord. The Bible says that a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, not wives. And he says, and the two shall become one flesh. So if you're already one flesh with one person, you don't have any more flesh to connect to another one. Praise the Lord. The whole flesh is taken up. Praise the Lord. And you see in the Bible, there are so many people that did not, that had two wives, that had three wives. Somebody will say, oh, what about Abraham? We are not following Abraham. We are following God. Praise the Lord. What about David? What about Solomon? They are not the author of our lives. The author of our lives is God. Praise the Lord. So we have to follow what God said, not what Adam did, not what Abraham did, not what David did, not what Solomon did. All those people did what they did because they were human. Praise the Lord. But what did God say? God says, a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Praise the Lord. And that is enough. You don't need any more explanation. You don't need God to go after every marriage and say, you. He has already said what he said, and that is final. Praise the Lord. So, and that is that brings the question of what about polygamy? What about all this? Amen. Because God has designed us in a particular way, and for us to do it perfectly, we have to do it God's way. Praise the Lord. Because only God designed this thing. It is not us. It is God. Amen. I will get into other things in the future. Praise the Lord. I'll get into other things. Today I will not get into them because I don't have the time to get into them. Praise the Lord. But pretty much today what I want us to build up is start thinking about your relationship. As a person, with your co-workers. But the most important relationship is your relationship with God. Praise the Lord. Because God is unlimited. Amen. God is able to do extraordinary. If you don't have a relationship with God today, I want to encourage you to start thinking about your relationship with God and take it seriously. I'm not talking about religion. You know, many people, when you talk about relationship, they think about religion. I'm not talking about religion. Religion is trying to please God. Relationship is what has God done? And myself accepting it and inviting him into my life. Praise the Lord. It is, you know, we are not trying to please God. God is already pleased with what Christ did. And if we accept what Christ did, then God is pleased with us. Praise the Lord. There's nothing I can do today to make God love me more. He already loves me with all he has. There's nothing I can do today to make God bless me more. Praise the Lord. Now I know some people are wondering, then why do I tithe? Why do I give? Praise the Lord. Now, the Supreme Court, there was a case that brought to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court said, before we make a decision, keep doing things the way we've been doing, and then we'll make a decision. Praise the Lord. Now, the same way, keep tithing, keep giving, until I tell you why I talked about those things. Don't stop. Because, you know, there's a pastor who said, who was talking about tithing and offering, and started talking about, you know, we scare you. I've also been part of those people who scare the church. And we will scare you, telling you God will beat you up if you don't tithe. God will do ABCD. And so this pastor came and discovered, unajua, God has blessed us with every spiritual blessing. Christ has died, all these things. It's like we are telling God, we're telling people you are blessed here, and then we are telling people, do this so that you can be blessed. Which is which? Are we blessed or are we yet to be blessed? Which is which? So this pastor finally came and said, you know what? You are blessed. It's not based on what you do. Then people stopped giving. Because many of them were giving because of religion. Many people give because they're afraid. You give because you're afraid God is going to do something to you. You know, I wanna, you know, we have to be free. Praise the Lord.
Unajua ubaya ukipatia Pastor Mike. At this time, let me just invite Daniel Atiani. Because if I say something else, praise the Lord. Let's put our hands together as we invite our brother Daniel Atiani to the mic. Yeah. Praise the Lord.